Stitchmakers! Happy New Week to you all. I hope that you are well. Welcome to Stitching the High Notes. My name is Joanna, and this is a channel and growing online business encouraging you to stitch creativity and joy, or the high notes, into your everyday life. I hope that you had a good week. I had a pretty good week. I started back at work this week, my day job, my work, and then I started to work a little bit for the shop as well, getting back to the sewing machine and the cutting board, which I'll be doing a little bit more of today. So I'll be taking you along on this studio vlog, a proper studio vlog again, kind of easing back into kind of the vlogging routine a little bit. I have updates on my knitting as well, so I guess we'll just jump right into it. This morning, you will have seen, I've started the I-cord bind-off on my peacock shawl. Oh my goodness, I'm so excited to get this off the needles, and it's gonna happen today. That's my main focus today. This is the peacock shawl by Emily Walton through Expression Fiber Arts. I cast this on in August last year using stash yarn from Legacy Fiber Arts in their 2016 colorways celebrating Hocus Pocus, the movie, the Disney movie. So I've got four colors in here. It is massive and humongous, and I can't get it all in one screen, so probably not until I block it and totally get it off the needles are we gonna see how big it's gonna be. I think it goes down to, probably when it's blocked, it'll go below my butt, so which was the hope and intention. Just a really, really large, snuggly shawl to wear when I'm outdoors, hanging out with friends, hopefully again soon, someday soon at the beach, or just hanging out with them outside. So, or just taking a walk myself on the beach. So excited. I had three repeats of this 3x3 ribbed bind off, and I decided to stop at about 2.5 of the repeats because I didn't want it to look like I had more green than the rest of the colors for the most part. The most is the color at the top, which I intended. And I probably in hindsight should have done a little bit more of this third color. This is Winifred Sanderson, I think Mary. I get these two switched up. Mary and then Sarah Sanderson. And then this is Spellbook, the final color. And oh, I love it, love it. So yeah, so I did 2.5 repeats, and then now I'm doing an I-cord bind-off. It just says bind-off in the pattern, but I love doing an I-cord bind-off. I think it makes a really, really classy, nice weight to a piece too. It helps with the drape of it. I took off the, you might have seen already, I took off the second needle on my big circular needle, because then I can just use the needle for doing the I-cord bind off, and it just makes it easier so it's not like weighted down with the weight of the other half of the shawl. I almost said blanket, but it is a schlanket, if you will. A mashup of a shawl in a blanket. So yeah, I'm really excited. I think I've said that probably 7 times already, to get this off the needles. It's a product, if you will, or a shawl, a piece that I've been really wanting in my wardrobe for some time, a really big, yummy shawl. I have at least one other that's like that as well, but not nearly as big as this one. So I'm really excited, and then I'm excited to cast on my next make, which is going to be my first sweater of the year, and that is going to be the Tender sweater. I actually decided, if you saw the last episode, which was sharing my 2021 intentions and goals for making this year, I was kind of in between the Forest, Into the Woods sweater that just came out by Melody Hoffman, and also the Tender sweater, which is also by Melody Hoffman from a couple of years ago, I think a couple of years ago, that had been in my queue for some time. And after thinking about it a little bit, I decided to do the Into the Woods sweater, maybe for my Rhinebeck sweater, and cast it on in late summer, because I just can, I only have time really to make one sweater until my cutoff, my personal kind of cutoff time for making winter garments is the beginning of March. So I think I only really have time to make one sweater, given that I'm going to be sewing a lot in the coming weeks again, and increasingly so. So, and the tender sweater I can see as a real staple in my wardrobe, whereas the Into the Woods still feels, I think it's something that I can see myself wearing in 5 years' time, but maybe not in 10 years' time. And I definitely can see myself wearing the tender sweater in 10 years' time, if that makes sense. I'm keeping that in mind also because I'm really trying to use local non-superwash, if possible, wool first. And I was able to do that for the tender sweater, and it's on its way. I made the order yesterday. So hyped. So when it's here, I will share it with you. I decided to go with a very similar light gray as what is in the design photo for the tender sweater. And just because I think it's really classic, it's a color that I don't have in my wardrobe sweater wise right now. I have really warm fall kind of colors, which is what I want to do for the Into the Woods sweater as well. So that's partially why I pushed it off a little bit too. But yeah, so I'm really excited to cast on. I can't wait for that yarn to get here. Should get here early next week, hopefully, fingers crossed. And I think I'm toying with casting on a pair of socks, but I kind of want to wait until I get a good amount of the sweater the sweater whip going. So I think I'm going to hold off on any socks for mama right now. But yeah, so that's the knitting update, if you will. I mentioned I'm going to start cutting again and sewing a little bit today. I really want to finish a book that I've been reading the last week or so. And which, by the way, first of all, thank you all for everybody for your lovely comments and for sharing your words of the year and your intentions and goals for the year in last week's studio vlog. It was so wonderful to hear what your thoughts are going into this year and for your feedback as well. So thank you so much. And also thank you for letting me know where you prefer for our community to kind of gather again after I've really missed having like a real dedicated focused community space outside of here on YouTube, for us to kind of share our whips and our ideas and any questions we have. The majority of you all said, let's head back to Ravelry. So some of you have already seen, I redid the Ravelry group. The links to everything are down below. And I did a big like fresh reboot of it, and I put all of the previous threads in archives, so you can still access them if you want to see old chatter threads for Mel's and episode show notes from back in the day and all of that. But right now there's just one thread, a town square is what I've called it, and it's our general chatter thread. Eventually we'll add on any make-alongs and things that we do, which also thank you all for your feedback about that as well. If you caught the premiere chat, because I usually do a premiere of each week's episode or studio vlog, and we chat about kind of how our weeks were going or any questions that kind of come up throughout the vlog. A lot of you all were like, let's do a year-long sweater make-along. And I think we're going to do it. We're going to do it. I'm going to open up a thread today at some point. So check out the Ravelry group for that. Or just take part here on YouTube. I'll probably think of some kind of hashtag at some point over on Instagram. But for the most part, it'll be here on YouTube and Ravelry that we'll kind of gather. And it'll be a year-long make-along for our sweaters. Whips are included. I always like including works that are already in progress. And it'll span throughout the season. So the summer, some of you were like, please continue doing the summer mal as well as the pumpkin mal. So I think the summer mal is a go, but it might be wrapped up more so into the sweater along. I just need to kind of gauge what my workflow is and what to do. But I love the summer along. It's been, the summer garment along has been like a tradition as well. So stay tuned for that in the Ravelry group. I also wanted to thank you all so much too for your wonderful feedback about my first kind of bookish vlog that I did this past Thursday. So much fun to put it together in a very different format and kind of rhythm than what I'm used to. It was a lot of work to kind of put into it to set it up because I hadn't done it before and I wanted to really make sure I sat down and mindfully thought about what I wanted to say about each book that I have on my to-be-read list this year and highlight which top five, and then I added on an extra, so it was top six to-be-read books or TBR. But it was really awesome. It was so much fun. I can't wait to do more. I definitely want to do a once a month video sharing what I had read the previous month and kind of some brief reviews, my kind of takes on what I had read. So that'll be coming up again in the next couple of weeks. I'll be sharing what I read in January. I want to do cooking and all that other stuff. Thank you again for your feedback on different kind of things that I could add to the channel on Thursdays, aside from our Sunday chats here in the studio vlog. I'm going to be actually adding a little bit of cooking today because I need to make a vegetable soup. I have some vegetables that need to be made into something ASAP before they go bad. So I'm just going to kind of do a little bit of a mix of a hearty vegetable soup that I've made in the past, but without the chicken broth. I have some vegetable broth because I'm really trying not to have too much meat aside from fish every once in a while. And I have eggs just because I've noticed this past year that my body prefers that diet a lot more. So anyway, so it's going to be kind of a make it as I go and experiment. So we'll see how it turns out this evening. But today I'm just going to finish up binding off a little bit, do a little bit of sewing, and I will check in with you all later. Just finished lunch and now I'm getting back to my little sewing area. It's getting some love again after a lovely break. I took most of last week off as I was getting into the swing of work again, and now yesterday and a lot today, I'm going to be getting into making bags and cutting fabric and whatnot. So I alluded to it before, I'm getting ready for my first collaboration with a yarn dyer, and I'm so thrilled and honored to be doing it with two of my dear friends, and I just had mentioned them earlier, Legacy Fiber Arts. Yay! We're going to be creating a special kit for you all with a drawstring bag and a colorway, a special exclusive colorway that goes with this fabric, a sock set. So it'll be fingering weight yarn with a lovely mini skein. And the fabric that we chose together is to celebrate Valentine's Day and this kind of time of love, but we didn't want to do like the traditional kind of cutesy Cupid stuff. So we were doing some research and I was reminded that Saint Valentine is also the patron saint of beekeepers and bees, and I love bees. I love hexagons. I mean, I have them over on my wall. I love all of that. I've had honeycombs and bees in my shop, which they'll be in the shop again, by the way, in stitch markers. And had seen this fabric a while ago, showed it to Sue and Chelsea, and they fell in love with it too, and were so inspired by the colors in it. So without further ado, here is the fabric that the drawstring bags are gonna be in. Here it is. Mind the wrinkles, cause it's just freshly still on the bolt. Oh my goodness, I love this so much. So as you can see, it has this lovely kind of yellow honey color all throughout it.
as different hexagon. It reminds me a lot of quilts as well. And oh, all these beautiful pinks and yellows, little pops of green. There's some light blue as well, as well as a beautiful blue background. Oh, just can't wait. And I'm pairing it with this beautiful honey-colored linen, Essex linen fabric, which just arrived late Thursday. So it's cutting time today. And let me sit down and chat with you all. Let me grab my little stool here. I love this stool. And let me move away from my little scrap bin there. But yes, so it's cutting time today, and also on Monday. I'm gonna really try to keep to my Sunday day off for the most part. But I'm really looking forward to working with new fabrics this for the first time in a while, actually. So it's gonna be lovely to be production line sewing again. I think Monday will be my big production sewing day, or the beginning of it anyway, as I work to get the first half of the bags to the ladies this week. They have yarn that'll be sent to me ASAP pretty soon here, so I'll be unveiling that next week in next week's studio vlog. And yeah, what else to say? Oh, so the collaboration kits will be drawstring bag only, and they are selected base for the sock kits. Fingering weight, as I said, along with a mini skein. I can't remember which base it is, but do keep tabs on their Instagram and their upcoming, hopefully, podcast soon. I know that they're planning to do one. And then once all of the collaboration kits are sold and you all have had a chance to get one, then we're going to open it up to the different varieties in our shop. So they will open up the colorway to the different bases and weights of yarn that they have. And then I will make, in this fabric, I will make sweater bags and maker's briefcases and notions and needlework pouches and whatnot. So yeah. So thrilled, so thrilled. I better get to it and stop yabbering. Oh, I did want to share this really quick. So this is my new rotary cutter. Oh, my mom gave me this for Christmas. She knows me so well. It's ergonomic, so I've got the safety off right now, but all you have to do is like press on this very gently, and out comes the blade, and then you lock it with the little button in the back. And then it's safe. It's a 60mm blade. What I usually use, is that right? Yeah, 60mm. What I've used in the past, so this was my trusty 45mm. And it's worked really well, but the amount that I was cutting, and especially because I've been cutting more and more in layers, I needed a larger blade. And I've been thinking about it, but mom, she knows me so well. She's my mentor in sewing, and she knew I needed the larger blade. And I've got to be careful with this puppy because it's no joke. So this one wasn't either, but my muscle memory is really in tune with this one, and I'm still getting used to this one. So that's what I'll be using today. Cutting for the day, and I'm eager to get back to my shawl. So I actually am gonna cook my soup now, even though it's like 3:30. But by the time it's done, I think I'll be ready to eat it a little bit and maybe nibble on it throughout the evening. I've been eating dinner pretty early. I'm like totally on this like early bird schedule, full force, where I'm like eating at 4:30 or 5 dinner. And waking up at like 5 and all that stuff, plus
Plus, I also want to eat earlier because I need to do yoga this evening. I've been doing it mainly in the mornings, but a couple of times, especially on the weekend, I'm noticing I like doing it in the evenings or the early evenings. So I want to eat enough to, or eat early enough so I can digest it and all that stuff. And I think I've been mentioning it over on Instagram stories, but I'm doing the yoga with Adrienne on YouTube, 30-day yoga challenge, if you will, but it's more of a like a practice to really start to reinforce it being a daily practice. I am loving it. I have many, many thoughts about it that, you know, as I finish up the process, I'll definitely kind of share how I've changed and grown through it. I'm on today will be day 15 because it started with day zero. And I just really, overall, I appreciate how slow the pace is, the build up to it. Each day is just really built out intentionally so that it's first and foremost reinforcing for this to be a practice and for you to come to the mat where you are at in your physical space, in your mental, spiritual space, and just to really explore the journey. And I'm shaking my arm. I've got to change it right now because I'm so sore from yesterday's practice. Some of the stuff we did, I was balancing a little bit more on my hands and a little bit in my like thigh area, or like doing a drop balance and stuff. So I'm feeling it today. So anyway, I'm gonna make that soup now, and let's start cutting all the veggies.
Tiptoe.
That was lovely. I had just about enough time to do the yoga session. I did stop briefly to put in the collard greens into the soup. Let's take a look. It smells amazing. Yes. It looks a little super done, but you know, ooh, foggy camera. It's soup. Let's do it. So yummy. I'm gonna tuck into this soup and then continue to bind off my shawl. It's gonna be something I'm doing throughout the day, maybe finish up early in the morning, we'll see. So stay tuned to Instagram and next week to see how it turns out. I'll definitely be blocking it next week. It's gonna take up my whole studio apartment to block it, or else that's what it's gonna feel like. But I'm so ready, and hopefully I'll get my new yarn next week too. I hope that you all have a wonderful week ahead. I will see you next Sunday. Bye.